mind. And anterior, this is the upper part. It is the perpendicular plate of ethmoid bone. Inside this bone is the ethmoid bone, and this is the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone. So the bony nasal septum, inferiorly it is formed by the vomer bone, and posteriorly it is formed by the upper side it is formed by the perpendicular plate of ethmoid bone. On the lateral wall, you can see some three shelf-like projections. These projections are called concha. These are concha. Further detailing of this nasal cavity is discussed in separate lecture of nose. So here you can already see the nasal septum, the bony septum, which is formed by the ethmoid bone and the vomer bone, three shelf-like structures. These are called the concha. So this is the nasal region. Again, I will repeat. This is the nasal region. Nasal region contains mainly nasal cavity. It is spiriform in shape, or it is pear shape. Above side it is narrow, and lower side it is broad. There is present a nasal septum which divides it into two halves. These projections are called the concha. Superior margins are formed by the nasal, inferior margin of nasal bone, and the rest of the margins is formed by the nasal cavity of maxilla. So now the next region is the zygomatic bone. First you can see this is the anterior view of zygomatic bone. This is the anterior view of zygomatic bone. This is the frontal process which runs upward. Here it is attached with the zygomatic process of frontal bone, and this is the, you can imagine this is the orbit. So the position of the orbit. So this is the lateral view. This is the temporal process. From here it runs backward and form the zygomatic arch, which explain in the which this zygomatic arch will explain in the normal lateralis. And here this surface is articulate, because here it is the position of orbit. So these are the inferior margins of orbit, infraorbital margins. So infraorbital margins literally formed by the zygomatic bone, and here if there is this bone which articulate with the this structure form the infraorbital margins. This bone is name is maxilla. Okay, one is maxilla. In the anterior surface of zygomatic bone, there is present a foramen. This foramen is called the zygomaticofacial foramen. In complete view, here you can see this is the zygomatic bone. This is the frontal process. This one is the temporal process, which moves backward and articulate with the temporal bone. And this one is the this surface articulate with the maxilla, and completely they form the infraorbital margins. And here the position of the zygomaticofacial foramen. So this is the zygomatic region. This zygomatic bone mainly forms the infacial skeleton, the prominence of cheek. It is called the malar prominence. The prominent part of cheeks is mainly formed by this zygomatic bone, and it is all this prominence is called the malar prominence. So I discussed about with the frontal region, the orbital region, the nasal region, and the zygomatic region. Now the fifth region is the maxillary region. This region is maxillary region, which mainly formed by the bone maxilla. First you can see the anterior view of maxilla. This is the anterior view of the separate bone of maxilla. In the maxilla it has four processes. One is the first process, because it runs towards the frontal region, the frontal bone. So this bone process is called frontal process. This process moves towards zygomatic bone. So this process is called zygomatic process, and this complete process is called the alveolar process. This alveolar process, they have the different many sockets for the roots of the teeth. So there in this anterior view you can see three processes: frontal process, zygomatic process, and the alveolar process. On the medial view, there is also another process. It is called the palatine process, which will be later discussed. In norma frontalis, I already told you about the anterior view of the maxilla. So in the anterior view of the maxilla, these are the three processes, and this one is the body of maxilla. There is present a foramen, and this foramen is called the infraorbital foramen. Through this foramen, or you can say foramen transmits the infraorbital nerves and vessels. It is below approximately 1 centimeter below to the infraorbital margins. This is the maxillary region. This is the anterior view of maxilla. This one is the frontal process, the zygomatic process. This is the nasal notch and the central line. They fuse together, called the intermaxillary suture. This one is the alveolar arch, and this one is the infraorbital foramen, which is 1 centimeter below to the inferior margins. So this complete region is called the maxillary region. Now, the sixth and the last region is the mandible region. So you can see mandible region is mainly formed by the which bone? Mandible. This is infraorbital. These are the openings, locations, openings present in the maxilla. So infraorbital foramen location, I already told you about the, this is present below the, approximately 1 centimeter below the infraorbital margin, and structures passes the nerves and vessels. This is the alveolar process, which is called location kya, lower process of maxilla, and contains the roots of the maxillary teeth. Now the mandibular region. This area, this is the anterior view of the mandible. This one is the mandible. So this is the anterior view of the mandible. In the anterior view of the mandible, you can see this one is the body. This is the ramus, and it contains two processes. This is the coronoid process, and this one is the nylar process, or this is the ramus, and this one is the body. Body has two surfaces, anterior surface or external surface, and behind it is the posterior surface. The superior border, this is called the alveolar border also, and this one is the inferior border. You can say it is the base of mandible. This is the base of mandible. So the features present in the anterior view of mandible, first, this is the fusion line. Initially, mandible developed in two halves. Later these two halves, they join together, they fuse together in the midline. And this midline is called, the fusion line of the two halves of mandible is called symphysis menti. This midline is called symphysis menti. The anterior surface of this symphysis menti, it projected triangular elevation. And this elevation is called mental protuberance. This line of fusion is symphysis menti, and this triangular projection is called mental protuberance. Because it is triangular, so it has two lateral angles. On two lateral angles, there is present two elevations. This is called the mental tubercle. Mental tubercle. From the mental tubercle, the oblique line arises, which runs laterally and continue with the anterior border of ramus. This is called the oblique line. This one is the oblique line. And there's, you can see there's present two foramens also, which mainly present below the second premolar teeth. Present below the second premolar teeth. Then foramen, these two foramen are called the mental foramen, through which, or you can say these foramen transmits the mental nerve and vessels. So the main characteristic features, or you can view in the anterior view of the mandible, you can see first is the symphysis menti, triangular region is mental protuberance. On the lateral angle of mental protuberance, there is present two mental tubercle. From a line arise from the mental tubercle towards the anterior border of the ramus. This is called the oblique line, and this one is the mental foramen. So these are the main openings present in the mandible: mental foramen, alveolar process. Anteriorly, the mental foramen, alveolar process, these two openings only visible. Mandible foramen is not visible in the norma frontalis. So mental foramen, these are the location, and these are the structures passing through this. Now the these are the attachments present in this picture. You can see these are the small in this lecture I told you about the small or some names of the some attachments of the muscles. Brief or in the detailed study of these muscles is discussed in separate lecture of face. So some few attachments of norma frontalis. First, this muscle is the corrugator supercilii. This muscle mainly attaches to the medial part. This is the position of the superciliary arch. This is the position of the superciliary arch. So this is the medial region of superciliary arch. So the corrugator supercilii attached with the medial region of the superciliary arch. Here also present a muscle which is not visible in this slide. You can see here this mainly present on the nasal bone, medial side of the nasal bone. This muscle is called the procerus. This is corrugator supercilii and this one is the procerus. Muscle is procerus. Now the muscles attached in the, this one is the frontal process of maxilla. So muscles attached in the frontal process of maxilla. First is the muscle is orbicularis oculi. It has three parts. Only orbital part of the orbicularis oculi is attached with the frontal process. Orbital part. Between, this is the nasal part of frontal bone. And this one is the frontal process of maxilla. So both frontal bone and maxilla attachment to the orbital part of orbicularis oculi. Between these two regions, there is present a ligament. This ligament is called medial palpebral ligament. Apart from these two, there is also present another muscle attached in front. This one is the orbicularis oculi orbital part, and in front of it, this muscle is called levator labii superioris elecnesi. Initially, they are slightly difficult to pronunciation, but as practice, we will remember these name of the muscles. So, this one is the levator labii superioris elecnesi. So, in the frontal process of maxilla, there are three muscles attached. One is orbital part of orbicularis oculi, medial palpebral ligament, and the levator labii superioris elecnesi. Now comes to the infraorbital margins. Just below the infraorbital margin and above the, this is the infraorbital foramen. Above the infraorbital foramen, this present attached a muscle. This muscle name is levator labii superioris. Below to the infraorbital foramen, below to the infraorbital foramen, there is attached a muscle levator anguli oris. The origin and insertion of these muscles will discuss in the separate lecture. In this lecture, I already tell you about the attachments. So this one is the levator labii superioris. This is the levator anguli oris. Along with the nasal notch, this is the nasal notch. Along with the nasal notch, the muscle attached is, this one is the nasalis. Below to it is depressor septi. This is depressor septi. Just below to the depressor septi, this muscle is called the incisivus labii superioris. This muscle is incisivus labii superioris. Here you can see this complete muscle. This muscle is called the buccinator, which also arises from the mandible and also arises from the maxilla. So this attachment is the buccinator. This muscle attachment of the muscle is buccinator. On the surface of the zygomatic bone, you can see there are present two muscles. This one is the zygomatic, this one is the minor, and this one is the zygomatic minor and zygomatic major. Zygomatic major mainly lies the lateral to the zygomaticus minor. These two muscles, this is zygomaticus minor, lateral to zygomaticus minor, there is present the zygomaticus major. So these are the few muscles which attached in the norma frontalis. First is the corrugator supercilii. Here is the location of the procerus. three muscles in the frontal process of maxilla, orbital part of orbitalis oculi, meet palpi ligament, and third one is which lies in front of the orbital part of orbitalis oculi is the levator labii superioris, elec nasi. Just above the infraorbital foramen, there is levator labii superioris. Inferior to it, there is levator anguli oris. Along with nasal notch, this is the nasalis, depressor septi, and the incisivus. And this one is the buccinator. Now, I summarize the norma frontalis. Was the foramen. So the total opening, so total foramens present in the norma frontalis is number 5. Three foramens, they line in the along the vertical line. This one is the supraorbital foramen, this one is the infraorbital foramen, and this one is the mental foramen. These foramens transmit the branch, three divisions of the trigeminal nerve. The first division arises from the first. So the supraorbital nerve, it is the branch of first division of trigeminal nerve. So the first division is ophthalmic division. This division is this from here the muscle arises the infraorbital nerve. So infraorbital nerve is a branch of second division. Which one is the maxillary division? This here the position of the zygomaticofacial foramen. I told you about the foramen which is present on the anterior surface of the zygomatic bone. The foramen is called the zygomatic facial foramen. The nerve passes through the from here, same name, zygomaticofacial nerve. And this zygomaticofacial nerve and also the infraorbital nerve, both are the branches of the second division of trigeminal nerve. This one is the maxillary nerve. So inferior, this is the third vertical line. This is the third nerve. Third foramen is the mental foramen, passes the mental nerve, or mental nerve is a branch of third division. So first division, second division, and third division is the branches of mandibular nerve. And fourth minute foramen sometimes present in the nasal bone through which passes the some veins. So major foramens are these, the total foramens present in the norma verticalis, number 5. Three foramens in a but line, in a vertical line. First one is the supraorbital foramen, this one is the infraorbital foramen, and this one is the ventral foramen. One foramen present on the zygomatic bone is called the zygomaticofacial foramen, and one pair of bone is foramen is present in the nasal bone. Now this is the norma frontalis. Let's summarize the norma, important features of the norma frontalis. We can divide the norma frontalis into 6 regions. This one is the frontal region. This one is the orbital region. This one is the nasal region, zygomatic region. This one is the maxillary region. And this one is the mandibular region. Enumerate the bones present in the frontal region. This one is the frontal bone, nasal bone, maxillary, zygomatic. And this one is the mandible. Sutures are visible. This one is the metopic suture. This one is the fronto-nasal suture. This one is the inter-nasal suture. This suture is fronto-nasal suture. This one is zygomatico-maxillary suture. This one is fronto-zygomatic suture. And the fusion line of the mandible, this suture is called the symphysis menti. And in the upper jaw, there is present centrally present suture is called the inter-maxillary suture. So these are the sutures visible in the norma frontalis. So the main norma frontalis, then the sutures are visible, then 5 foramens. Now the features of the different regions. In the frontal region, this center point is called the nasion. This point or the inferior end of the internasal suture is called the rhinion. This one is rhinion. This one is nasion. This centrally present elevation is called glabella. Here the curved elevation is called the superciliary arch. These are more prominent, the superciliary arch is more prominent in males. They are frontal tuber. These frontal tuber are more prominent in females and children's. This one is the zygomatic process of the frontal bone. the zygomatic bone. The important feature, there is present a foramen, zygomatic facial foramen. In the maxilla, there is present a foramen, infraorbital foramen. Because of the presence of the roots in the sockets, there also present some elevations and some depressions. So centrally present depression is called the incisive fossa, because this is formed by the two roots of the incisors. So this fossa is called incisive fossa. And this elevation is called canine eminence, because this canine eminence mainly formed by the, because of the root of the canine teeth. So this is called the canine eminence. Lateral to canine eminence, this depression is called canine fossa. Elevated area is called canine eminence. Depressed area lateral to it is called the canine fossa. This is fossa, this is canine eminence, and this is the incisive fossa. This one is anterior nasal spine. It is the prominent structure, anterior nasal spine. These are the conchas. These are the, this one is the nasal septum. Lower part is the vomer bone. Upper part is the perpendicular plate of ethmoid bone. This one is the mandible. Mandible, features of mandible is the symphysis menti. One triangular area is mental protuberance. These two features, these two projections are called the mental tubercle. This one is the oblique line, and this is the mental foramen. So this is all about the norma frontalis. सर से बंद कर दीजिए अब, कैसे बंद कर अटेंडेंस कैसे दे? हाँ जी सर, अच्छा दिखा देती हूँ। अच्छा ये स्कल दिख रहा है सबको? उन्हीं से पूछ रही हूँ सर, स्कल दिख रहा है? सो सिस दी सर, एक बार मैं एक बार फ्रंटल रीजन के बता दूँ ना, सिस दी नॉर्मा फ्रंटालिस, बस मैंडिबल नहीं है। अच्छा ये रहा, नॉर्मा फ्रंटालिस, ठीक है। अब इसमें देखो सब लोग, दिस वन इज द नेजल बोन, दिस इज द नेजल नॉच, दिस एरिया दिस इज कॉल्ड द ग्लैबुला, दिस वन इज द सुपर सिलियरी आर्च, दिस सुपर सिलियरी आर्च, दिस इज ग्लैबुला, दिस एलिवेटेड ऑन द बोथ साइड, दिस एलिवेटेड एरिया इज कॉल्ड फ्रंटल ट्यूबर, दिस फ्रंटल ट्यूबर, superciliary arch, glabella, this is the nasal bone, this one is orbit, this is the suture present between the frontal zygomatic process of frontal bone, and this one is the frontal process of zygomatic. So this suture, zygomatico frontal suture, this is zygomatic bone, this one is maxilla, this line of suture is called the zygomatico maxillary suture. This is infraorbital foramen. You can see this is infraorbital foramen on the both side. So one is nasal cavity. अंदर कुछ नहीं दिख रहा है, इसमें टूटा हुआ है, इसे यहाँ पे present होता है nasal septum. और this one is the alveolar arch. This one is alveolar arch. This is maxilla, mandible or. This is mandible. You can see these two foramens are the mental foramens. This is symphysis menti. This triangular elevation is called mental protuberance. This is the mental tubercle. And this oblique line, this is not clearly visible. This is the imaginary, this is the oblique line, which starts from the mental tubercle and runs backward and upward, continue with the anterior border of the ramus. This one is the ramus. these are the two processes. This is coronoid process, this is the condylar process. So this is mandible, this is norma frontalis. So the two cavities, two orbital cavity, one nasal cavity. Bas sala band kariye, kaise band karna hota hai. अब एक बार सब अपने अपनी बुक से पढ़ लेना, आ जाएगा समझ में।